De Vicuita Ficona sinus is one extremely endangered animal, with only, according to some estimates, 40 to 90 individuals living. There are only habitats is the Gulf of California, also known as the Sea of Cortez. They are living around something like 20 years, and only once in two, sometimes more, years they're getting young. They live in small groups of maximum 10 individuals per group. They are very shy animals, and they have large black loops around their ears, which remembers some little bit of a panda. That's the reason there are sometimes called the pandas of the oceans. They are critical in danger because of commercial fishing gear. The majority are catched in commercial fishing gear, mainly gill nets, but also ghost nets, and sometimes when they're a little bit injured, they can be trapped in troll nets. But troll nets also affect the habitats and space of the animals that live there as well, because troll nets are actually large controls, matched with trapped by large controls that actually put a hole into the ocean and take anything with it. It destroys coral reefs, and it takes large amounts of bycatch as well. Most of the time not the Vicuita, but so far I know, correct me if I'm wrong, if you have a study that shows that Vicuita has also been trapped large in control nets. But other animals that live there are absolutely trapped in that kind of nets. And turtles are also trapped in control nets. There are the equal in the structure power, with a little bit exaggeration, of course, as a bulldozer that destroys rainforest. On the moment, according to the last statistics I have read about the state of the ocean of 2004, the only 10% of the world oceans are not overfished. 90% of all the oceans is fished or overfished. Only 10% not. And if you ask me, with the state of the oceans in on the moment that there is, I say all forms of fishing is overfishing, if I be honest, completely honest. But net furthermore to the Vicuita, for the people who are angry on me because I support tactics that maybe can make fishermen more poor, I say to them this. If the Vicuita become California, Mexico's mascot animal, since they only lived in that place on the earth, I think the Mexico government can make jobs for the ex-fishermen that stop with fishing, so that they can show tourists on places where, if the Vicuita get a chance to repopulate, well, to show the Vicuita. They are very cute, they have very black, very big black spots. They look adorable. And yes, they are shy. And since their numbers are so small, there are not so much sea. But when the numbers become greater again, they will be seen more. And people can actually make money off of eco-tourism, which is a form of ecological friendly tourism, which actually includes that people go on boats and see the nature in the place. If you have good people that know the region good, They can show the people a lot of beautiful places in the Sea of Cortez. There are a lot of opportunities in that kind of arena, I am sure. Evolution is a question from evolving. And if fishermen are too stubborn to change their pasts and their culture of fishery in a culture of ecotourism, then I damn not have respect for them. I understand the position, I truly understand, but I have no respect for cultures who benefit from the exploitation of other living beings. Specific, if it is not necessary. If we can put a man on the moon, a design and a computer that can play chess and with absolute surety, we can sustain the whole Earth on a plant-based diet. The Vegeta is also nearly on top of their original food chain. There also are optimistic feeders, meaning they are not picky eaters. When they are disappearing, that can increase the populations of small fish and then decrease in populations of plankton and phytoplankton and small marine species. They're being eaten by different kinds of whales. A decrease in plankton will cause also a decrease in species such as baleen whales. Vegetas also are sometimes prey of the great white shark and the orca. So if they're disappearing, there also can come problems with the populations of that kind of animals. So as I always say, no environment, no ecosystem, no web is a species on its own. If you affect one thing, other things are also connected in the process. You don't target always one thing. If you take away something out one ecosystem, you also will negative affect other things. That's one law of ecology, third law of ecology. All species are interconnected. A decrease in biodiversity is nothing good for an ecosystem. And anybody who don't believe that, I will suggest that you take some history lessons and look on the collapse of the Atlantic fishing plant of 1992. The collapse of the Atlantic fishing plant in 1992. It suddenly collapsed. Reason? Fishermen or fish slave traders were actually fishing too much of the fish out of the ocean. Don't look on the effect their business have on the ecosystem, and actually committed ecoterrorism. I mean true ecoterrorism. Since environmentalists are not ecoterrorists, even the mentally ill American government believes that. Animal rights activists are not terrorists. Listen good, FBI. Environmentalists and animal rights activists are not terrorists. We are the ones who try to protect endangered species. You are the one who supports cruelty. If you are against animal rights groups and harass them. Because you're on a corporate whore, the stand after the shit heads of the people who have money to hire you. For example, Smithfield with Lily Pig. Then you are the fucking terrorists. Supporters. By default. Must I also remember you that you have trained the people of ISIS? So you have said to Powerson of C-Shepard, you trained them. You are responsible. So, it's time to take your little medicine. But yes, furthermore, there's no secret that the Mexico government and the Mexico people in general have not so good image with the drug cartels and the kidnapping and other unsafe things happening and the spreading by the media as a fire. But if the people actually can show to the world that they give about the environment and give about their own biodiversity more than Donald Trump, I'll actually give nothing. And miraculously helps to recover this beautiful cetacean, this beautiful creature from extinction. I think this will be pretty good for the image of Mexico. If they are disappearing, the Vaquita will disappear. This will absolutely be terrible for the Mexico people and for the Mexican government and give more despise against the Mexico people, and that will absolutely not come. So, come better. So I suggest for Mexico to change their ways of fishing, at least in that place, and adopt a more vegan lifestyle. Check out Challenge 22 for some vegan inspiration. And boycott fishing for good. Because we don't need fish to survive, and the fish. So I have explained are critically in danger. There's not only the vaquita, but there also are many other species on the planet. How we are in danger because of commercial fishing. No wonder if you look that in general, fisheries have some 5 pounds of bycatch on 1 pound of intended fish, with some industries even more. For example, with shrimp, is 20 pounds on 1 pound of shrimp of bycatch. The vaquita is also a pretty likely target of bycatch in the shrimp and then blue shrimp farming. Because there are use or in general gill nets for that, how are the most biggest nightmare for the conservationists of the vaquita. But so I have explained in this video, it is not the only danger for the vaquita. The best thing you can do to help the vaquita is going vegan. And inspire people to do the same thing. There are many of alternatives for fish today. I put the link in the description below if you want to check it out. On a website how sells different kinds of plant-based fish products. And you can check out my video about how I make plant-based animal products subsistence on my other channel, and Vegan Mods. When darkness and light become one, the reality splinter away and the truth become visible. In 2006, the Beijing River dolphin was extinct. If you ask me, this has to be a wake-up call in that time for conservationists, how critical in dangers and how much in the collapse of a state our oceans are. Now we are right on the plate of being in danger of losing another endangered species just a couple of years later. If we claim to be the most wise and powerful species on the planet. It is our responsibility to protect endangered species from our own stupidity or from our own destructive behavior. Depends on how you look to it or your means of communication. We have the responsibility to stop our own species from destroying our environment. That is what the sensible thing to do is. If you ask me, if we are not capable of doing this, we have not the right to call ourselves humans. Since being human, since the word human, in its etymology and historically wise, are mean the same as humane. And humane means with mercy. Humane means with compassion. Humane means benevolent, not malevolence. Furthermore, destroying an entire species just for some money or for some conference is simple evil. There's no other word for it. Specific is it being totally unnecessary, and it is totally our fault. Furthermore, like the Cambridge Declaration of Consciousness explained, all animals are sentient and aware to the degree that we are, and the vaquita is a smart animal, much like we claim to be as well.